Good afternoon, dear participants. Welcome to the last part of our third virtual webinars and conferences today. I'm very glad to present our next guest. He is a teacher from Tarija. It's our dear friend Juan Rojas. Before we start with his presentation, I would like to tell you something about him. Franz Juan Rojas has been working as an English teacher at the BNC, Centro Boliviano Americano Tarija, for almost 10 years. He has a bachelor's degree in agronomic engineering and graduated from CBA Tarija in 2010. He has a pedagogical theory and practice diploma, additionally, a diploma in development of online teaching programs TESOL 2021, sponsored by the U.S. Embassy. In addition, he has been part of the Trainer for Secondary School English Teachers Access, TOT, sponsored by the U.S. Embassy. Currently, he's a teacher trainer at the program English Plus 2.0 BOA workshop sponsored by the U.S. Embassy of English Teachers around Bolivia. Franz has also attended several webinars, conferences, conventions, and workshops in Cochabamba, Sucre, and Santa Cruz related to English teaching methodology. He attended the TESOL convention exhibit in Atlanta, Georgia in 2019. Franz has been working with all ages students, so he's eager to learn and share. Good afternoon, Franz. Thank you very much for being here. Thank you for representing CBA Tarija. And we are eager to learn from your presentation today.
Thank you so much, Cinthia. It's a pleasure to be with you. So thank you, CBA La Paz, for this opportunity. So today we are going to talk about podcasts.
Great. Let me share your presentation. Microphone is all yours.
Thank you so much, Cinthia. Okay, so we are going to start with the podcast, the potential of podcasts to improve students' learning. So the main objective for this kind of session is to help new teachers and provide this technological tool information about the advantages that we have and the way we how we can motivate our students. So first of all, I will ask you a quick question. So have you ever listened to a podcast? What do you think about the use of this kind of technological material inside our classrooms? So what do you think about us? Do you think that it will work?
Please, teachers, feel free to answer the question on our chat box. Meanwhile, I can tell you that probably I have never used podcasts in a classroom. I know they have very different topics, and I think it's a great material for listening and also for producing, language during the classroom.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Cynthia. Yes, you are right. So with podcasts, we can help our students and increase their motivation. That's the main point that we want to talk about today. So first of all, we are going to establish our objectives. So what do we want to get with this kind of session? So first of all, we want to encourage teachers and students to use podcasts. So we are going to see the lots of advantages that we have with podcasts. The second one is that we want to visualize the extensive range of podcast advantages. As you know, after the pandemic, we have it was so hard for teachers to work in reduced environments, right? We couldn't interact with our students. But in this case, podcasts help us a lot because we have the chance to motivate our students and also give them a lot of material, because a podcast is like a huge library, and there we can find like a lot of information that are related with any topics. So it depends on the level and the way you planify your activities. So it's going to be a nice resource for us. And yes. The last one is,
I'm sorry to interrupt. I just want to tell you that, most of the teachers are answering your question. Before, they said that probably we can use these podcasts as an authentic material. They say they are a great tool for students to practice listening and also increase critical thinking. So I have a lot of teachers that probably already use podcasts and they are giving their opinions. It says that Joe Rogan podcast, but I don't know how exactly take advantage of it in my classes. So that's what you are going to teach us today. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Cynthia. Thank you so much for your help. And the last one is try different activities to motivate a student's discussion and participation in the class. So keep in mind that some of our students are feel shy, so they don't feel confident enough to express their ideas because sometimes they have the feeling that they don't have the ability to connect expressions, to connect their ideas. So that's the main problem. They feel stressed sometimes. As teachers, the way we can help them is giving this and sharing this kind of technological source with them. So we are going to continue. First of all, we want to define what is a podcast. Podcasts have been around for almost a decade, and so we have a definition. A podcast will be defined as a digital audio file created and then uploaded to an online platform to share with others. This was established by Philip 2017. And here we have to keep in mind that nowadays voice media plays a vital role in impacting our leisure time and the way how we want to get entertainment. It can be whether with a music platform, a listening podcast, or maybe radio, right? But now we are going to focus on podcasts. So why they are nice for our students? We have to keep in mind that nowadays our students, as I mentioned before, they feel frustrated because they can't connect ideas. But in this case, we are going to share this kind of rich source with them, and we are going to help our students to get more information and see how these kind of platforms are using English, right? And we are going to listen native speakers. In that way, they will be confident enough to express their ideas. Why? Because the main problem that our students are having outside the class is that when they listen an audio and it gets some interruption, some noise, they can understand, they can focus, right? So that's the main problem that we have in our classes. But also we have to keep in mind that most of these audios are played out at real-time conversational speed with true life accents. That's really important for us as teachers. So as teachers, we have to be interested on these types of podcasts. We have a lot of podcasts, but we are focused on these ones. First one, we have the authentic podcast, the teacher's podcast, and students' podcast. So what about authentic podcasts? In this case, they are not designed for EFL classroom. So they are like a genuine source of real language material use. So in this case, we are going to find some long interviews, monologues, or stories, very big. So in that case, we can consider this kind of podcast for those students that are advanced students, or for those ones that really want to practice their English because they have finished their studies, right? So it could be a nice way, and it could be also a nice way for teachers, because as teachers, we need to practice, and sometimes we tend to forget because of lack of practice of some vocabulary words, so we need to practice, right? And in this case, it's going to be nice for both as teachers and students at the same time. The other one, we have teachers' podcasts. In this case, this kind of podcasts are created by teachers and they use it as a real material that they created for their class. The main objective is that they want to cover their needs. So they created this kind of podcast and they use in their classes and they share with their students based on those materials that they like to use in their classes. So this is one possibility. The other one is that we have like a students' podcast. So these are created by students in response to some topics that maybe the teachers give them, like segments, right? Assignments. So in this case, our students create them, but also we have the chance to give them as projects, right? So they are going to use podcasts to respond to any topics or to comment. But at the same time, they will listen to the podcast. They will get an idea how podcasts are structured. What are the steps that they have to follow to get a nice podcast. So it's going to be so nice for our students to get this information. So we have to continue. First of all, now we are going to listen to an actual podcast. So why? Because we need to get, maybe as teachers, we have listened to some podcasts, but now we are going to listen to a well-known platform that gets a lot of podcasts. So here we go.
I'm Steve Ember.
And I'm Phoebe Zimmerman with Explorations in VOA Special English. Today we tell about a very popular musical instrument. Listen and see if you can guess what it is.
Okay, as we have listened, these kind of audios are friendly with our students because they motivate our students and they are not so boring, right? Because we have a lot of sounds, a lot of music inside those, and the speakers are so friendly because they have like nice conversation between them. They are like interviews, right? But maybe you are so worried because you can use this kind of podcast with beginners, with students, with adults, with teens. But what about for kids? In this case, we have another source. So listen again, please.
Good evening, children. It's Granny Macduff, ready with a story. So make yourselves comfy, and I'll begin. Once upon a time, there lived a king who had three sons. The elder two were clever and wise.
Okay, as we listen it here in this part, we have this kind of podcast that work nice with the students because they help the motivation that our kids need, right? And also they have the chance that we can practice with them the real English. Indeed, in that way, they will start learning some words, some expressions, because as you know, students not just listen once, they listen the same audio once, three times, four or more, right? Because they like. So in that way, they are involved with those kind of words and they feel the motivation to listen as many times they want, right? So that's really, really interesting for our students. Okay, so we have another one here. So these ones are related with science, for example. Keep in mind that sometimes we have activities in our books that are related with different topics, right? The lectures that we have in our books. So we can select some specific audios that are related with science, some these ones that are related with better ways to improve our life. So we have different audios, right? Some of them are so motivating because as we can listen here. So listen, please, again. Okay, as we have listened, those audios are not boring at all, right? So they are so motivating. Sometimes if our students feel like tired or they think that they won't like, so maybe we have to try to share with them some kind of audios. In that way, they will identify that some of them are so nice and so excited. So it means that as teachers, we are giving them more information about some kind of things that are really going to motivate our students. So that's incredible, right? So as teachers, we have to consider those kind of things. But now you are worried, right? About How are you going to find them? Where are you going to find them? And what are the steps that I have to follow to find the best podcast, right? So in that way, we have to consider these ones. Podcasts are presented by big dose educational companies that we have that share audios. But in at the first glance that we can identify here, not all of them are shared with for our beginners. Why? Because they are shared for those students that are high level students and those that have the chance to express themselves without any problems, right? So in that case, we can see like BBC gets a lot of podcasts and they are shared in this way. So they are easy to download if you want to share the audios. This is one advantage that we have about podcasts. If we want to share podcasts about the last news, so this is one way. For example, if we want to make activities about the news, if we want to active, as teachers mentioned, their critical thinking, they express their ideas, they communicate themselves. So we have to use these kind of resources. If you want to look for a specific podcast, so this is going to be a nice way. So start with global news podcasts. So they are available for teachers and they are free. So maybe you are worrying about if you have to pay. No, they are free. So we have the chance to download them and use them with our students. It doesn't matter if you are giving information about news or if you are teaching some students for specific purposes. So there you have like a lot of material and you have the chance to share with your students. So this is going to be like the first option. More information about podcasts. In this case, we can visualize that here we have like a lot of topics. So it means that information can, students can get information about a lot of topics, right? About sports, about music, about a lifestyle, about family, about health. So we have like a big range of podcasts that can help us to introduce different topics that we have in our books or to design different activities because we want to motivate our students and give more information. The main objective is, as I mentioned before, to show our students the importance to use them to focus on their improvement, right? So we want them to improve, express their ideas without problems. And also they get more information. As you know, nowadays our students are so anxious to get more information, right? So they consume, they like to get sources where they can get more information and enrich their knowledge themselves, right? So this is a nice way, as we can see. So this is another one, we have BBC. In the case of those that are not interested to get more information about news, about sports, as you know, our students have different modes depending on their age. We have some interesting other kinds of podcasts. For example, in this case, we have about scary stories, funny stories, even though there we can find like comic stories that are related with podcasts. So this is going to be a nice way to engage our students because that's our main objective, engage them and help them to improve their English, right? So here we can have another one. So this is a big possibility. Maybe you are worrying, yes?
Sorry, I have some questions from the audience. First, course. They are eager to have the sources of this material you have. They are asking for the links and the pages where we can find them. And one teacher asked, can we use podcasts with the students that are in basic English?
Yes, yes. Just give me some minutes and I will get there. Okay, thank you so much, Cynthia. Okay, in this case, if you want to look for these specific topics for about podcasts, you can find them on Google Podcasts. Just you have to type on Google the name of the podcast and you will find them the solution, your answers. Why? There you will get all podcasts that you need about any topic. For example, nowadays it's easier to get this kind of podcast. As you can see, we have them on Apple Podcasts, on iTunes, a Spotify Podcast. This is a free page. We don't need to pay. And we have Google Podcasts. These are the three well-known pages that online that we can get the podcasts we need. Okay. Okay. So about the for beginners, right? So we are going to find the answer. In the case you want to introduce culture, you want to help your students to get more information about culture, and you want obviously provide them more information, so we have some blues podcasts. So this is another way the how we can introduce them in the culture of American people, right? Because they are going to be involved with those kind of things. And probably they will like some kind of things that they really motivate them to get them, because podcasts are published once a week. So it means that if you get there, you are always connected. So they are divided sometimes by chapters. So they have the chance to listen once a week or twice a week, depending on the platform where you are signed up. So it depends, right? As we can see here, we have the blue podcast. It means that you don't need to get a paid account. You have a free account. And this is going to be nice for you as teacher to share the link. It means that your students, they don't need to download the app. They don't need to pay. Just you have to share with them the link. That's it. If you prepared an activity, just you have to share the link with them. And that's it. But if you don't want to share the link with them because it's so difficult for them, or they don't know how to download or get inside the page, so you have the option to download the audio and share with them the audio. It depends on you, okay? For the next one, as I mentioned before, and to answer the questions that some teachers are so anxious to get the answers. So in this case, we have the chance to consider VOA, Learning English. Why? Because inside this web page, we are going to find a lot of material. As you can see here on the picture, this is divided for beginners, intermediate levels, and advanced levels. So here we have a lot of audios and a lot of videos. But keep in mind that when we talk about podcasts, the main objective is to reduce the students' screen use. So you don't want your students to check the screen all the time, right? Because if they are at home, like me, for example, I start thinking or watching through the window or doing other things, so I lose my concentration, right? But when we are using podcasts in the class, so it means that your students have to be concentrated. They have to be focused, and they have to get the information they want doing different activities, different things. Right? They don't have to necessarily watch the screen, see the screen, and being there paying attention all the time. Right? So this is something nice. If you want to check for VOA, it's going to be a nice resource, and you don't need to download the page. Just search on the Google tool, and there you will find a lot of resources. So VOA is the solution for beginners. This is the first option for beginners. And you will find there like information for beginners, intermediate, and advanced level, and a lot of resources like videos, about movies. You will find about news, about art, about technology. So it depends the way how you are going to organize the activity and the way you want to deliver this kind of information with your students. So we have to keep in mind those kind of things. And something awesome about this page is that we have, as we can see, to download the audio directly. So we don't need another app, nothing. Just we have to click there. We have like normally two options, and we have the chance to download the audio and share with our students. But if we don't want, we want the option to embed the link or get the link by Facebook, by WhatsApp, or just copy the link and share it with our students. It depends on you, teachers. Okay, for the next one, we have another page. In this case, we have the Post Alley. So this is a page that is always posting the best podcasts that we have around the net. So they always post the best podcasts. And here, obviously, you have to consider this kind of page for those high level and intermediate students, or for those ones that are so anxious to get more information and practice their English, right? So in this case, you will find those that are the best ones, okay? So this is the other one. So now, for example, I take as an example from VOA. How are you going to find them? Some of them have the transcript or the audio scripts, or you will find them that they are structured in this way. So it's going to be easier for you. Keep in mind that some of them are very long, like 1 hour, 50 minutes, 45 minutes. So they are very long. But what is nice about podcasts that they are divided in sections, right? So maybe you liked a specific part. So we have the chance to cut it out and select the part that we want to work with our students. So just we have to analyze, listen carefully the podcast. So this is one presentation. It's not the same for all patients. So we have to be careful because some other patients don't offer this advantage to get the audio scripts or the translations. So we have to keep that in mind, okay? And something great about this is that here we have vocabulary, right? So here we have some words that are established and maybe they are divided by sections, as I mentioned before. So our students get the chance to get them, for example, like a vocabulary, if they are nouns, if they are adjectives, whatever. So we have the chance to analyze with our students and give this information. Obviously, we have to keep in mind that some of our students tend to forget some specific words, but maybe after we listen it with them, we have the chance to add more words inside this vocabulary section and to help our students a better understanding about this podcast. In other cases, for example, if we talk about a podcast for a first level for beginners, we have the chance to use a BBC. BBC gets a specific podcast for beginners, right? Why? Because there we can find activities like these ones there. After they listen it, they get the transcript or the translations or the scripts. So they have the chance to complete some activities that they have in the page. So they have the chance, as you can see, they have to order the words, the expressions. So it depends. So this is the first option. In the other one, we have like some activities that they have to fill in the blanks with some specific words that are already there. So they have to choose the best ones. So in that case, they check their understanding. So that's something incredible. So they have the chance to check their understanding. So these are some activities. So don't be worried, because at the time you start looking for a specific information with all these tips that I am giving you, you will find those pages that really work well for you. So maybe you would like to use them, or maybe you will use other options, or you will divide them by maybe for beginners, for intermediate level, or for high level students. As I mentioned before, the presentation is different from page to another page. In this case, if we decide to use this podcast that is really interesting for kids, what if who? In this case, what if, right? So here we have like a lot of hypotheses, and children have the chance to get the audio script like in this way. Okay, so we have to help them, or maybe we have the chance to provide them, read with them, and they will answer their questions, because most of these podcasts use a lot of idiomatic expressions. So that's another problem that our students get inside the class, right? So sometimes they want to translate word by word, and that's the main problem. Because these kind of expressions, as you know, they are kind of difficult to translate. So we have to try to understand them depending on the context where they are placed. So we have the chance to explain them and they get better ideas at the moment they are using this kind of podcast and the ways they have the chance to use these expressions, right? The other one is like these ones. As I mentioned before, they are easy to download. As you can see, you can find arrows like this one, some directions to get the audio, and some difficult expressions, some words that are difficult for our students are highlighted. So you have the chance to create your own vocabulary with them and classify the words depending on the functions, how they are working inside the podcast, right? So not all of them get, like, for example, like BOA, like a section of a specific vocabulary. In other cases, we have to create our own vocabulary because they don't have those kind of advantages. About, as I mentioned before, about BOA, there we can find a lot of resources, and they are divided by sections. They have like a vocabulary sections, and some of them get quizzes inside the platform, so students have the chance to complete some activities, or they have some questions at the end that active their critical thinking. Okay, so it's clear. Do you have any questions there before we move? No. Okay. In this case, we are going to see this record. Sorry.
Hi. I'm so sorry to interrupt. I was just with my microphone off. It happens. I have some questions from the audience. One teacher asked if these podcasts are downloaded on Spotify already. I guess you already answered, right? Are the podcasts in Spotify?
For example, when we want to use Spotify, it depends. Some of them offer that option, but others not. In this case, we have the chance to just share the link. Okay. But obviously, as teachers, we have the chance to get like the free option, and it's not necessary to pay. So most of them are free. So that's for sure in all pages.
Cool, thank you. Another teacher asked, which of these podcasts would you recommend to use with teenagers?
Okay, for teenagers, I would recommend, for example, BOA. Here, there we have like a big range because they talk about food, they talk about presidents, American presidents, about national parks, about some outdoor activities that you can do. So it depends. So it depends. Why? Because keep in mind that not all our students like the same things. So maybe if you want to place like an activity inside your classes, you have to divide them like sections. Like if you have like 25, so you get four groups, right? Four groups that are going to do different activities with the same podcast. Why? Because if you give them the same activity, they will get bored, right? Because they have the chance to copy between them. It means that not all of them are going to work the way you want. So you have to be very careful there. And also, at the moment they start exposing their work, it's going to be kind of worrying for all of them. So bored, right? Start listening all the same things. So sometimes they get bored. So we have the chance to give them different activities. In that way, all of them are going to work doing the different things with the same audio. So that's why I gave you like a lot of options, but don't worry. At the end, I will share some links, and Cynthia is going to share with you. Please, Cynthia. Okay.
Just one last question. Another teacher asked, how can podcasts be implemented in assessment?
Okay. In assessment, it depends. For example, we have to keep in now. That's what I'm going to explain for the next slides is that, for example, dictations, we can use them as a listening comprehension. So maybe we have the chance to give our students the opportunity to listen a specific section of the podcast and write them down. Or you are going to give them the way that they have to analyze the structure, how it is structured. So you have like the main sentence, the topic sentences, how it is structured. So maybe if you find a small podcast, like 5 or 6 minutes, so your students have the chance to identify the main topic, the main sentence. So in that way, you give them, if you probably you are teaching them the way they have to write a nice paragraph, so this is going to be a nice way. So you are giving them the way that they have to look for some specific sections in this kind of paragraph. So it could be a one way.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Okay. As I mentioned before, Audacity is a recording software. So what it means? For example, if we get those big podcasts, right? So now we are so worried. It's so big. And if I share this kind of podcast with my students, they will get bored. They will say, no, teacher, you are crazy, things like that, right? So what do we have to do? We have to use this kind of software. Why? Because it let us to cut, to edit, and to choose the section we want to work on with our students. So we have also the chance to add our own voice, to edit, to add some effects. It helped us a lot. As you can see, for example, the audio I shared it with you, I did it by myself. So I'm so sure that you are going to do it by yourself, because it can look a little bit intimidating, right? The front page, but please don't think that. Sometimes things can look like a little bit intimidating, but they are not. So for example, if you need help, we have the chance to look for tutorials on YouTube, right? But if you are not well, and if you don't like to work with these kind of apps, with these kind of softwares, and you think that they are so hard to operate or things like that, maybe we have the chance to ask our students. So they are so anxious to help you, because as you know, our students know a lot of about technology, and sometimes they do their things, because as you know, nowadays our students are TikTokers, YouTubers, so they like and they know how to use this kind of softwares that are really easy to use. And so sometimes if you want to get directions, our students in this case are going to be so anxious to give you a hand and help you with the problem that you are facing. Okay. Okay, so we have to continue. Why do we use podcasts? So this is another question that we have. So I point a lot of things. So now you are worried, but what happened with these kind of things? So many of them are offered under a Creative Commons license. What it means that we don't need to get the author permission to modify it, to adapt it according to our needs. So they are free, and all of them are under Creative Commons license that let us to cut them and select the sections we want and work with them, obviously in a teaching classroom, right? So we are going to use them to practice with our students. So they, and also they are free. That's, they are some of the advantages that we have with podcasts, that we don't need to get the author permission to adapt or modify these podcasts. Another point that we have to consider is that, so now you are maybe worried about these kind of things, but we have to read a little bit. Audio learning plays an incremental role in learning for young people. For instance, when words are spoken aloud, children can understand ideas, so that's really important for us, that are two or three grade levels higher than their normal reading levels. So Fleming states this in 2017. It means that at the moment we are using audio, it helps our students to get more vocabulary words, to get more expressions. They become accustomed to listen those words and they learn. So they have the chance to apply those kind of expressions at the moment they are exposing their ideas. So that's incredible, right? So because we have these kind of advantages with podcasts. More advantages. We don't need internet connection. In this case, if you are getting like a poor internet connection bandwidth, so you don't need to get it like a big one. So it's easy to download, and no internet after we download. So it means if we download on our cell phone, on our computers or laptops, we don't need to use internet after that. Another thing that is incredible about them is that they are MP3 encoded. So they are going to play, they can be played on all devices. So there is no problem. And they don't take a lot of internet bandwidth, right? And we have like a lot of topics that are always related with those units or those readings that we have in our books. We are going to mention more advantages. They are, for example, innovative teaching. So why they are innovative, you are asking? Because nowadays they are trending, right? Why they are trending? Well, so we have to keep in mind that our students are followers of most influences on the media, right? Those influences constantly are posting a variety of information on social network, right? So it means that our students get information from them. So first they were TikTokers, as I mentioned before. Now they create podcasts, maybe in Spanish, but we can find a way to use them in English, right? So it's going to be nice for them. Another point is like learning benefits. So we can do some kind of activities, not just inside the classroom. So we can give them activities to do outside the classroom. That it means that teaching is not going to be just in the classroom. So they have the option, the opportunity to open their minds and see that English is used outside the classroom. And you are giving the independence to the students to get more information. And probably in the future, they will be the ones that are going to suggest you some podcasts that you may use for some specific activities that you would like to, or they will be the ones that are going to share with their classmates and push their classmates to use podcasts as teachers, right? Because the objective is that we have to make spread this kind of podcast through word of mouth, right? Why? Because we want our students to get the best of the 21st century. So in this case, would be podcasts to motivate our students to gain the confidence they need for our English classrooms. The next one is going to be improve students' reading, writing, and concentration. So you are asking maybe how our students are going to improve their reading. So for example, keep in mind that first of all, our students have to concentrate, have to focus when you are sharing the audio. It means that they don't have the chance to read it, right? So that means that they have to concentrate and they have to try to remember those words that they learned previously. Those vocabulary words that you learned, the grammar that you learned, everything. They have to remember a lot of things, and they have to be prepared for those words that are coming so fast, and they have to identify them. In that way, you are helping your students to use that kind of vocabulary that they are remembering, that kind of grammar they are remembering, vocabulary words, everything, to speak, to express their ideas. So that's why we not just make an emphasis that podcasts can be used as a way to improve and speak in the class, because they have the chance to communicate, not just speaking, to communicate, because at the moment they are communicating with their partners, with the teachers, they are using the English. There is an interaction between the students and teachers, right? So it's easy for them. Also, at the moment of improving writing, so they have the chance to see how these kind of podcasts are structured, as we mentioned before, right? So they see and they have to identify the topic sentences, the supporting sentences, the examples, so we can make an analysis with them if we are practicing writing, for example. This is going to be nice for our students, and they will be accustomed to use this kind of methodology. Why? Because they will be listening all the time. So these are some activities. Keep in mind that this kind of podcast don't want to replace the age-old textbooks that we use on our dominant curriculums in the class. We want to use the podcast to serve as a tool that is going to give our students another way to learn English. So that's something really important that we have to point, right? And the last one is that podcasts are going to help them and also are going to improve their concentration, because students, when they are on YouTube, for example, that's a nice resource if they are checking, if you are using TikToks, right? So they have the chance to visualize the video, right? But sometimes they lose their concentrations, and so they are not focused all the time, right? So they don't keep the focus all the time, but when they are listening an audio, like when they listen music, they are concentrated. Yes, they keep that concentration. So you are helping your students in that way. So that's why we can point out that we are using a podcast, not just inside, but also outside the classroom. Why? Because they are increasing the accessibility. Why? Because they can listen podcasts everywhere, whenever they want, and it doesn't matter what time is it, so they have the chance to open and get the podcast they want to listen, right? And also podcasts encourage their engagement. So it means that they are connected and always they want to get more information about them. So they will obviously choose the ones that they will like a lot and they will reject those that they don't like, right? So you are going to be the ones that is going to help them to get a lot of information about podcasts and help them to get and get like a specific selection, right, for them. They can be listened at any time, wherever, and they are flexible and availability. So it means that they can get a lot of things. Some kind of things that we have to consider, we have like communicative structures aspect. As we mentioned, they have to analyze the presentation of podcasts. They have like a writing description. So not all of them, but most of them, they have this option. So we have to keep in mind at the moment we decide to select a specific podcast. So we have to consider these kind of things, if they are going to be for intermediate levels or higher levels. About being with an intro. So all of them start with an intro. Some intros are, as we have listened, really nice. They are so interactive. So they are not worried. They are not like a big speech, right, that our students get bored. And we have some theme music that helps us to relax like a little bit, and then we have to concentrate again, so we get the energy again, focus, right? And they always focus on specific topics and they stay on the topics. So what it means, for example, if you want to talk about why some video games are famous right now, why a lot of teenagers are playing them. So you have like a clear explanation, not about how you have to play for that game. You have like an explanation why they are so trendy right now. So you are getting more information. And obviously, as we can hear, so the first option is for adults, for those at advanced levels. So let's listen a little bit. In that case, you don't get bored.
Support for this podcast comes from Wise, the smart way to move money internationally. Meet Wise, one account for over 50 currencies, because today your life is bigger than one currency. Whether you're sending pesos to your parents.
Okay, this is our first option. This is about TED Shorts, because we have TED as podcast, not just as TED Talks that are available on YouTube. We have TED Talks that are podcasts, and we have the chance to share with our students. This is one option. We have another option. In this case, we have the Poop Collector. That's kind of funny, but at the moment you start listening, you get a lot of information that is going to be useful for your students, not just for English, but maybe for the other subjects where they need to get more information, right? So listen.
Hi, I'm Lindsay.
And I'm Marshall. Welcome to Tumble, the show where we explore stories of science discovery.
Today, we're meeting a scientist who collected his poop every day for a year.
Did you just say collected his own poop? Why would anyone do that?
You'll find out when you hear the incredible, hilarious, and very stinky story of what happens when science gets very, very personal.
For example, answering the question that a teacher asked like some minutes ago, so here it can be nice for teenagers, for example, the Poop Collector. And like this, we have, they are on Spotify, like this, we have like a lot of podcasts and they are funny in that way. So the names are funny, but then they explain why it's the meaning of that. So they provide a lot of information, right? So we have to continue. Okay. As the teachers mentioned, they are considered like authentic material. Why? Because they show a real use of language in the classroom and outside the classroom. The second, in this case, podcasts present content that is high interest. So it means that if we want to get more information about some topics, we have to look for some specific podcast. Next, they present and they talk about current topics. It means that nowadays we have some events around the world that are trendy. So they talk about those kind of topics. And also they help students to learn more information about the topics they would like to. And at the same time, they will get more information. They enrich their own vocabulary because they get more information and the way how they can express those ideas. And also increases the students' motivation because their students will find like a lot of information. At any point, they would like to talk about those kind of podcasts that they really love or like. So in that way, we can give them the chance, the opportunity to talk about them or create their own podcast, which is going to be great for our students, right? Okay, so here we have activities that can be done using podcasts. The first and the most obvious one, we have the listening comprehension. In this case, for example, our students have to listen the audio and guess what the title is. So you always do this kind of activities, teachers, right? So we are always doing these kind of activities, but now we have the chance to do these kind of activities with podcasts. The next one is, so what is the name of the following topic? What are the names of the characters? Maybe they have to write down some keywords that they didn't understand that are associated with the topic. So we have like this one. The other one is that we are going to listen with a glossary. It means that listen to the audio and guess what's the title. So what is the name of the following topic? And then write some keywords associated with the topic. If the students didn't get some vocabulary words, they have the chance to ask for. Or maybe if you are preparing an activity like this one, it means that first you have to listen and filter the part that you want to share with your students. So you are going to create a vocabulary. Keep in mind that probably you choose a podcast that doesn't have an audio, and that doesn't have a vocabulary section. So you have to create that section and then you have to share with your students. Okay, so this is an activity that we have. So create a glossary of new terms. Maybe there we have like idiomatic expressions or things like that. Then we have to hand this out before playing the episode and let your students use it as a guide during the listening and add more information if they want to, right? For the next one, we have like summarize. So in this case, students listen and then summarize the episode using like 6 steps. This is just an example. Identify the sections of the text. So you have to, maybe that's the grammar that you are explaining them on the classes. So now you are going to give them like homework that they have to do, not in the class because it takes time. So you are going to assign it as a homework. So they have to identify the section of the text, distinguish between major and minor details. So it's going to be nice. Remove minor details and examples and pay attention to the transition words that the podcast is using. Reorder the ideas as needed. Maybe you disorganize the ideas or you created a practice or something like that. And reserve your opinions, like provided it is a trendy topic, so they have the chance to share their personal points of view or things like that. For the other one, we have like filling the blanks. I choose a section. So maybe in the section you want to add or the words that they have to use to complete the paragraph, but maybe you think your students get these words and they are accustomed to use them. So maybe you think that it's not necessary to add them. So they just have to listen and write them down, filling the spaces, right? So it depends on you. For the other one is like they have to make predictions. So you are listening the audio with them or you listen at the audio with them in the class and you give it as a homework. So your students have to make a summary of this episode and they have to make like a prediction what is going to happen next. So they have to write like 2 or 5 sentences. And then the next time you are going to play the audio again with them and you are going to check if the work they did is right or wrong. So it depends on you. As I mentioned before, dictation. So keep in mind that this is a great method for improving both listening and writing, but usually there are problems because some of our students think, teacher, you read too slow, but maybe for others, you read too fast. And in this case, you assign as a homework. So it means, like an example, listen to the episode and transcribe the text from, you give like a specific instruction from a, like my example, right? So they have to write it on their houses, and then you will correct in the class. So it could be one way, right? Keep in mind that at the moment they get this kind of podcast, they have the option with some of them to reduce the speed of them. So it's going to be nice. For the other one, when we talk about listen for gifts, so it means that our students have to listen once and they have to compare their answers. It means that you will give them like specific questions that they have to identify. For example, what is the episode about? Who is speaking or who are speaking? What's the main topic? What are they talking about? Where are they? What is the general mood of the conversation? If they like it or not? So these are some kind of things. For the last one is like let your students to choose their favorite ones and make a presentation about it, like a project maybe at the end of the unit. It depends on you teachers. So we have let them make their own podcast once they understand the concept of podcast. It means that previously you get like a lot of practice with your students. So they are practicing all the time with you. They listen it. So you analyze with them. So they know the structure of podcast. So in that way, your students get a clear idea how they have to work with podcasts and the way they have to create them. So keep in mind, if we want to create our podcast, just we need a mic and our cell phones. And if we want to edit, we have to download the software Audacity, and it's going to help us a lot. So it's not a big process, right? So just easy things to do this. And I am so sure that maybe your students will love these kind of activities and are going to be so engaged. Keep in mind that when properly implemented, podcasts are going to improve a lot of activities. If we don't assign or we don't prepare like specific activities about what we want to get from this podcast, the activities are not going to be the best. And obviously they will just listen the podcast and they will get the idea that they are just for entertainment. So it means that they are not going to pay attention. But at the moment you start using them, so you will explain them that they have to use for some specific activities and they have to complete some specific tasks that are going to motivate your students. Keep in mind that the purpose of podcast is to offer learners a supplement to existing instructions and a way to receive high quality instructions beyond the boundaries of the traditional classroom. That why? Because Kennedy is asked about this, and it means that we don't want our students to use English just inside the class. We want them to use outside the class. So we are going to use podcasts to help them in this process. And for conclusion, we have to ask these questions. Why should students not be using the most up-to-date technology? If we keep in mind that nowadays, after this pandemic, most of our books are updated, right? So we have resources that are available online, so they have the chance to get there and complete some specific task. So the question is, why shouldn't my students be using the most up-to-date technology to improve and be better, right? So in that case, we have to consider these kind of questions. And keep in mind that podcast is similar to a public library that delivers any material or resources needed straight to the users. So in this example, I think that's clear about that. And we have like the success of implementing podcasts will depend on how well teachers and students are able to incorporate them as a part of their class curriculum. So if we prepare nice activities and if we engage them to do some specific tasks, so they will get a lot of benefits from podcasts. So that's all. If you have any questions, so please ask.
Thank you, Franz, for your presentation. Well, one question that some teachers had is, how can students and teachers create their own podcasts?
Okay, teachers can create their own podcast related. For example, keep in mind that, as an example, probably we are talking about food inside the classroom, but we have, like, in each city, we have like a specific food, and this food adds its own story. So maybe the as teachers, we can motivate our students to talk about food, not just about the ingredients, but talk a little bit about the story of that specific plate, where it comes from, things like that. So they have the chance to add more information about that. But keep in mind that we have to keep it short at the beginning. And first, we have to practice as much as we can with podcasts.
Thank you, Franz. Well, we are almost on time. We surely appreciate all your tips you gave us. As teacher Maricela Pacheco said, we have never seen podcasts like this before. So it was really interesting. Probably all of the audience is right now a fan of podcasts. We are going to use that in the classroom for sure. With all your tips, it's going to be great. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much for sharing all this knowledge with us.
Thank you so much, Cynthia. Thank you so much, all teachers. Thank you so much, Sibiele Paz, for the opportunity. So it was nice to be here and share this kind of information with you.
Thanks to you. So I hope to see you soon on the next conference. See you.
See you. Goodbye. See you, Cynthia. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
You're very welcome. Goodbye. So please, audience, stay tuned. We still have one more to attend. And thank you very much for being here.